Thankful Bishop, thank you for just the opportunity to come together with Mama and just, you know, we appreciate you having us and giving us the opportunity to come and fellowship together and worship together this morning. Let me just take a moment and give my wife a chance just to greet us and then we'll be able to proceed with the service. I'm just so excited to be here this morning. It's wonderful to be together with you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. We thank God so much for the opportunity He's given us to come here today. We are happy to be here. The last time we were here was, I think it was about more than 15 years ago. And the church was small. We found a very small group of leaders and all. But I can see, Pastor, God has been at work. And we thank God so much for what He's done. And we pray that God will continue to do greater things through you and through all of us. We thank God for that. Amen.
Well, praise God. Thank you very much. Please appreciate my wife as she takes her seat. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Father, we just want to open our hearts before you now for the word. We thank you for the ministry of the Holy Spirit, speaking to our inner man, God, and transforming us today by the power of the word of God, not by might, nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. We pray that you'll descend upon this place like dew, and that the glory of God will envelop each and every one of us, O God. Let the presence of God saturate our hearts and our lives, and as we leave this place today, let our testimony be, it has been good to have been in the house of the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I really do honor Bishop and Mama. Hallelujah. Like Bishop said, we've had a wonderful fellowship and friendship and relationship for many years. And it's just wonderful to be together. I always tell Bishop he's one of the most accessible bishops that I know. Just a wonderful man of God. And, you know, together with Pastor Mwithi and the others. And, you know, we had the opportunity to be together several years back. And yes, just like my wife said, I'd like to echo what she said. It's wonderful to see just what the Lord has done. You look wonderful today. Now, amkutuambia, mgetutumia SMS tumutuambia, although my wife alikuwa more in the spirit kuniliko. Hallelujah. Maybe she should preach today. Baby, wanna preach? Hallelujah. Mimi nimekuja hapa Western, lakini hakuna shida. Hata ingawa tumetokeko huko pande ya Western ni. Hapana shida kwa sababu tunajua tu Mungu atakuweko pamoja na sisi. Nikikombe tu cha chai nilikunyweka asubuhi. Ikafanya nikafaa tai kwa sababu najua wakati mefaiko tai na nakunywa chai na telemka msuri. Bwana asifiwe sana. Praise the Lord. What time is it? What time is it? What time is it? Well, yes, it's 9:25. But what time is it? You know, as we walk together with God, there are times and there are seasons that God has ordained for our lives. Each and every one of us here is in a particular season of time. You have a wonderful opportunity as you are right now to engage in the timing of God and to draw and receive the fullness of what God has for you right now. Hallelujah. You know, God is a wonderful God, and He ordains times and seasons for you individually, but He also does ordain times and seasons for us corporately. And there are things that He ordains, not just corporately, even as a congregation, but He ordains times and seasons for entire nations. Then He ordains times and seasons for the entire earth. And so there are timings of God that are very crucial for us to understand, because whatever time it is in God's calendar is the most important time. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. God has a wonderful... Thank you so much, Brother Francis. Yes. Amen. I met him this morning and he's a wonderful man of God. Praise the Lord. God has ordained it to be that there be certain times and certain seasons that are important for our understanding, because in those times there are great and wonderful things that are in store for us if we can appreciate what time it is. If you go with me to the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3, It's a scripture we all know, very familiar passage of scripture. You know, but and you know, it talks about several seasons there. In fact, when you look at it, there are about 14 different categories of things that the writer, the preacher, you know, which we believe is King Solomon, what he said about the importance of recognizing the times. You know, if you look at verse 1, there, it says, to everything there is a season. Everybody say a season. And a time. Amen. There's a season to everything, to everything, to everything. There's a season and there's a time. For example, there is a season to get married. And all the 14 to 24 said, there's a time and a season. There's a time to get married. There's a time to have children. There's a time to, you know, engage with college. There are particular seasons in our individual lives. And God says there's to everything, there's a season and a time for every matter or purpose under heaven. There's a time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. There's a time to kill and there's a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And on we could read. And in other words, what the preacher's here saying is, he's saying, look, there's a particular time when certain things are appropriate to do. If you try to do them at a different time, they will become inappropriate. And so it's important to know what time it is, so the appropriate thing to do at that particular time, you engage with that appropriate action, then you benefit from the fullness of what God has intended for you in that particular time. Glory to God. And so God has a time, and there's a season and a time for what God, I mean, this is a season and a time in your life when God is achieving and doing something specific and something important. Because when you know how to respond appropriately to what God has ordained for you, you will never be the same again. Bible says in the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 12 and verse 32 that these men came together, 200 chiefs from the tribe of Issachar. And the Bible says the men of Issachar were wise and what? Understood the times. Amen. Of the sons of Issachar who had understanding of the times. To know what? What? Let's read it together. To know? What Israel ought to do. Their chiefs were 200 and all their brethren were at their command. The men of Issachar. Now, the background to this story is it was a season and a time for David to become king. And so all the tribes are coming back together to make David king. The tribe of Judah, the tribe of Benjamin, Naphtali, and all the others were coming together and they are coming to make David king. And they are talking about all these wonderful, you know, soldiers and wonderful, you know, army guys who could sling a stone at a hair's breadth and not miss, and all the wonderful skills and abilities they had. But he comes down to verse 32 and he says there was a certain tribe that had people who somehow from this particular tribe, they had a supernatural capacity and capability to know the time. Times, to understand what Israel ought to do. Hey, my brother, you might have wonderful skill, you might have wonderful ability, you might have wonderful strength, but if you use it at the wrong time or for the wrong purpose, you can end up in more trouble than if you just kept quiet. Hallelujah. And so it's important to have skill, it's important to have capacity, it's important to have power, it's important to have ability, but more than ability is the ability to have understanding of the times. Because when you know what time it is, you can then do something powerful with your skill, with your ability, with your capacitation. All that you're able to do becomes aligned with the purposes of God, and then supernaturally you see victory coming through in your life. Hallelujah. And so the men of Issachar understood the times. And so the question is today, what time is it? Now, like we said, individually, you might be going through a particular season of time. In the Greek, there's two words for time. It's the word chronos, where we get the word chronological. You know, it basically means just a sequence of moments. One moment after another. One moment after another. That's chronos. But there's the other word for time, which is kairos. And kairos means the opportune time to do something. When a baby is conceived in the mother's womb, the appropriate time, the appointed time, the unpostponable time for that baby to be born is 9 months later. Hallelujah. Here is the thing. There is a time for that baby to be born. And when that time comes, it's a kairos moment for the delivery of the baby. And there's nothing you can do about it. You can't postpone. You can't stop it. The only thing you can do is kill the baby.
If you don't get it, if you don't give it birth at that time. And that's why it's important for us to understand. What time is it? What Kairos moment are we in? Now, for you individually, there could be a specific season that God is taking you through. But there's a time for us corporately, especially as the body of Christ, that we need to be aware of so we can respond appropriately to what God wants us to do. Hallelujah. There is a need for us, once we identify that time, there is a need for us to align with what God is saying, with what God is doing, because there is something powerful. Glory to God. For us as the body of Christ, right now, in this hour, there is something great and glorious that God wants us to participate in. Hey, and let me tell you something. I don't want you to miss it. I don't want to miss it. I want to be right in the middle of what God is doing. I want to be right dead center in the middle of the purpose and the plan of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to know that I'm right in the middle of where God wants me to be. I don't want to be outside of the purpose of God. I don't want to even be outside of the timing of God. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Jeremiah chapter 17, you know, it talks about how blessed is the man who does not trust in the arm of the flesh. And you know that scripture. And then it says, but he who does not will be like a shrub. He shall not see when good comes. Now, let me ask you a question. Won't it be a terrible thing? Hallelujah. For you to kimbia ufike mahali, won't be, oh, good was just here, it has just gone. So you were there, you even knew you were supposed to be there, but you were late and you were outside of the time. And God wants us to be on time with what God has purposed for us to do. Now, here's the thing. Because God does not want you and I to miss it, God has then therefore prepared and purposed and promised us that we, his people, will be able to tell what time it is. Hallelujah. Mungu anataka tujue ni wakati gani. Kwa sababu yale ambayo amepanga sio ya kwamba amejipangia mwenyewe. Amepanga ya kwamba wewe na mimi tuweze kuwa partakers. God is a wonderful daddy. Hawezi kutengeneza machapati na manyama na nini na kuku na kila kitu na mbuta. Mahali hapo mezani ati yeye mwenyewe akule na ajibe peke yake na watoto wanamwangalia hivi. No, God prepare. Bible says God prepares a table for you in the presence of your enemies. Hallelujah. Because he wants you, his son, his daughter, to partake and to receive of what he has made available. So that's why he makes sure you can tell the time. Ndio Mungu wako na clock yake ambayo inatuambia saa hii ni saa fulani. Saa hii ni saa fulani. Saa hii ni saa fulani. Brother, see your son. Because he doesn't want you to miss it. He doesn't want lunchtime to come and you come at 2 o'clock when lunch was closing at 1:45. So God has a clock and a calendar. Hallelujah. God wants us to receive and to understand. Now, in Genesis chapter 1 verse 14 through 16, the Bible says that God put lights in the heavens. It says he put the sun and the moon and the stars in place. Hallelujah. And then he says in verse 16, it goes on down in verse 16, he says, these are to be for days, for months, for years, and for signs and seasons. So God wants you and I to understand the time, but he has put his clock in the heavens. So when you look, that's what Jesus said, when you see all these things begin to happen, look up, for your redemption draweth nigh. There is a place for us to look at to identify what time it is. God does not want you and I to be ignorant of what time it is. So the times of God are tellable or are readable from what God has put in the heavens. Do you remember in Matthew chapter 2 when the Bible says that wise men from the east came to seek and to say and to seek Jesus because they said, we have seen his star. Now I know we're not talking about the horoscope. Hello? How did these men, wise men, how were they able to know the time? How were they able to interpret correctly and say, that star means the Messiah of Israel has been born? How were they able to know? Because God said, I will put in the heavens the sun, the moon, and the stars, and they shall be for times and seasons for you to know and to appreciate what God is doing. Glory to God. Now, of course, the enemy comes to pervert what God has done. That's just his character and his nature. He comes to pervert, and that's why there's a lot of corruption, corrupting the proper plan of God with these horoscopes. And all that. We don't look at that. As guys, we are born again. Lakini, scripturally, Let's not throw out the baby with the bath water. Hallelujah. Ladies, ukiogesha mtoto, unatupa maji nje na kwa basin, unatupa maji nje pamoja na mtoto. Unasema hii mambo ya kuogesha imeisha, wacha nitupe nje. Maji pamoja na mtoto unatupa nje. Ni nini unafanya? Unatupa maji na unawacha mto? Like, kwanza unachukua mtoto ndio unatupa maji, si ni kweli? It's the same thing. We need to appreciate scripturally the foundation of what we are talking about is in the scriptures. Now, God says it shall be for times and for seasons. Hallelujah. And then another way that God has set his clock for us to read, he says in Leviticus chapter 23, Bible says, if you can turn there just for a moment, just look at Leviticus 23 here for just a moment here. Leviticus 23 verse 1 and 2. You'll see what God spoke to Moses. He said to Moses in chapter 23 and verse 1, he says, the Lord said to Moses, say to the Israelites, the set feasts or appointed season, I'm reading from the Amplified, okay, the set feasts or appointed season of the Lord, which you shall proclaim as holy convocations, even my set feasts are these. And then he goes ahead to give him the seven feasts. Now, God says, these are my feasts. Now, when you and I hear the word feast, we ordinarily think of food. Hallelujah. But that word in the Hebrew is a Hebrew word called moed, which literally means appointed times. So what God is saying is, these are my set appointments. You know how doctor anakuambianga hiyo nani alikuwa anasema clinic this morning, pastor, what's your name again? Pastor Theory was talking to us about the clinic this morning. You know when you go to a clinic, you're given set dates. You're told ukuje tarehe flani na tarehe flani na tarehe flani. Those are set times for you to go to the clinic. Now God says, here are my set times. And he says, these are appointments between me and my people. Now please notice, the Bible does not say, these are the feasts of Israel. Read your Bible. It doesn't say, these are Jewish feasts. He says, these are the feasts of the Lord. Now, if they were the feasts of Israel, then, you know, we would say, okay, Israel was shughulike na hiyo. But these are the feasts of the Lord given to Israel to be an example and a pointer for us, the rest of the people of God. If you belong to God, you belong to the people of God. And therefore, then, you are part of those who whatever is of the Lord is also yours. Hallelujah. So God says, these are the feasts of the Lord that you shall keep. And they are these ones. And he gives them the names and the timings. And, you know, he says that these are on these my set feasts, you shall, you know, have a holy assembly. The people are to come together and have a holy assembly and a holy convocation. It's interesting when you study that out, you'll discover that the word convocation or the word assembly is another Hebrew word, mikra, which means to call out. It means to gather, it means to recite. It also means a rehearsal. It's a rehearsal. So when you put them together, these are my set appointments on which you shall have my rehearsals. Now, it's important to keep that in mind because when you proceed, it becomes even more exciting and interesting. When God gave the feasts of Israel, he gave the feasts of the Lord to Israel. He gave them seven feasts. Passover, which we've just partaken of right now for us, okay? Passover, then we have unleavened bread, we have fast fruits, then of course we have Pentecost. Now, in the first month, you'd have the first three, Passover and unleavened bread and fast fruits. Then after 50 days, you have Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost visited the church, amen? And then on the seventh month, you'd have the other three feasts, which are trumpets, the Day of Atonement, and the Feast of Tabernacles. Now, those are the feasts of the Lord. God commanded them that you are to observe these feasts because it will be a representative and there will be dress rehearsals, as it were, of what God wanted to do now. That's why it's very important when you look at the timings of God. When you look at the timing of God, remember we're talking about the season and the time. What time is it? When you study it out, and it's all over the scriptures, especially in the New Testament, it's exciting to discover that when Jesus came, he came exactly, in fact, Jesus died at exactly the time of the Feast of Passover, to the day. In fact, when Jesus was arrested on the 10th, Jesus was arrested and taken for trial and all that. It was on the 10th day when the lamb that was to be sacrificed was to be gotten from the flock and then set aside until the 14th day. It's the same thing that happened to Jesus. So if the Jews had been really receiving the message of God, they would have understood that the timing of the Messiah, the timing of the coming of the Son of God, would have been on the feast of Passover, and the Lamb of God would have been slain. The lambs they were slaying were just a picture of this Lamb, the Lamb of God that would be slain for the salvation of your soul and my soul. The timings of God. So when you look at the feast of unleavened bread, Bible says Jesus said, I am the bread that came from heaven. Hallelujah. And he was without sin. That is the meaning of unleavened bread, is without sin. Eleven in the Bible is a symbol of sin. And so he was the bread that came from heaven. He came and he died. Unleavened bread took on our leaven, our sin, and he died and was buried. And the Bible says that the third feast in the first month is the feast of first fruits. And Jesus rose up from the dead as a first fruit unto the Lord of the resurrected brethren that will gather together one day around the throne of God. Hallelujah. So we have this feast. And so when Jesus came the first time, he fulfilled all those first three feasts. And then of course on the day of Pentecost, we have the coming down of the precious Holy Spirit. He was the fulfillment of that feast. But then there are three feasts now in the seventh month that we haven't quite seen, and they obviously, because they are timings of God, there is a message in those feasts that is for us, that we are supposed to receive and understand, so that we can be not in the same, so in other words, we should be in the same position that the Jews were in, otherwise they would have been able to identify, this is Messiah when he came the first time. But they didn't understand, they didn't know, so they missed it. So there's a message that we need to appreciate for us as the Church of Jesus Christ, that is contained, you know, that is within this feast that God appointed in the seventh month. And that's, you know, the seventh month is around this season and time now. This is really exciting, brothers and sisters. I'm really excited about this, and I really want to just take a few minutes and just share this briefly this morning. According to the calendar that Israel keeps, that they follow from the days of Moses and on, you know, whenever God began to work and to deal with them. According to them, this month we are in, September, is now, according to their calendar, is supposed to be the seventh month. In fact, the seventh month began on the 14th of September. On the 14th of September in our calendar, that's the first day of the seventh month on the Hebrew calendar. Now, on that day, hallelujah, whew, thank you, Jesus. On that day, that first day of the seventh month is what said was to be celebrated the Feast of Trumpets. Praise God. When we were worshiping, I saw a certain sister here with the feast, she had a trumpet, she had a vuvuzela. Hallelujah. Alikuwa, I was very happy. I said, okay, praise God. God is saying something. The Feast of Trumpets. Now, it's very interesting what this feast represented. On this feast day, and let's use the word appointment instead of feast, on this appointed day, God commanded the children of Israel that on the first day of the seventh month, that day you shall celebrate the appointment, or you shall keep the appointment of trumpets. Now, what is trumpets all about? God said, on that day you will blow trumpets and signal the coming in of the day of the seventh month. Hallelujah. Why? Because, several reasons. Because number one, the seventh month was the month that the holiest day in the Hebrew calendar fell, which was the Day of Atonement. The Day of Atonement would come 10 days after on the 10th day of the seventh month would be the Day of Atonement. That's the day that the priest would go into the Holy of Holies and he'd offer sacrifice and he'd give, you know, whatever he was to offer there with blood, so the sins of the nation could be forgiven for that entire year. Then they start another year. And so the Feast of Trumpets would signal the Day of Atonement is coming. Get ready. Hallelujah. And people would begin to prepare. So the Feast of Trumpets is significant because, number one, it was a signal and a reminder to the people to prepare themselves. Hallelujah. To prepare. It was an appointment to ready the people of the big day that is coming. Hallelujah. It was a celebration. It was an appointment kept to remind the people that the big day is coming. Glory to God. Now, these trumpets that were blown is very interesting. The pattern that would be followed. They would blow four different blowings of the trumpet. which was different from any other feast they would celebrate. So they would blow four trumpets. Now, listen. The first trumpet would be a long blast like the vuvuzela. That one is a wake-up call. Everybody in the whole land will know, oh, we are in the seventh month. Something is happening. There's a change coming. Can somebody hear something? Can somebody hear something here? The day is coming. The day is coming. It's a big blast. And they will know the day is coming. Hallelujah. So it's a wake-up call. Wake up and begin to prepare yourself. The second blow will be a blow that will be something like boo, boo, boo. That blowing was, it's a broken sound. And that was to cause the people to begin to repent. To get ready. To begin to get to repent. And it's a broken sound. It's a kind of blow that they would blow when somebody had died or lost a loved one, for example. So it was a sign of grief and sorrow. And so they begin to repent and to humble themselves before God. The third blowing was a blowing that went something like this. It was called the sound of the alarm. It's like, get ready now. It's right here. It's right on the door. And then the final trumpet will be a big blast that they'll call the long blast. Boo! For the longest time that the blower could hold their breath. To say what? This is the last trumpet. It's final. It is done. It's accomplished. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, I want to let you know, hallelujah, that this past season, about a couple of weeks ago, you know, this Feast of Trumpets was being celebrated in Israel. Now, we don't celebrate with the Jews. We are not Judaists. We are not practicing Judaism. But they are the feasts of the Lord. So when we know that appointment time, which God said is to be for all generations, it's supposed to be the Feast of Trumpets. How does it apply to you and me as a believer? Let me tell you how it does. It says to you and I, every time you see that appointment date coming, it's a sign of God saying, hey, listen, remember, you need to prepare yourself. The time is nigh. The big day is coming. Soon and very soon, the king shall come and descend from the clouds. So you better get ready. You better prepare yourself and make sure your heart is right and heart is ready. God doesn't want to come and find you and you'll be caught up like a thief. Or like you'll be caught up, you know, that rather. I'm thinking faster than I can speak. God doesn't want you and I for the day to catch us like a thief in the night. Hallelujah. God wants you and me to be prepared. When God is going to come back, he wants you to be knowing, hey, the time is nigh. The time is near. Prepare yourself. Repent. Clean your heart. Cleanse yourself. Make sure you're clean. Why? Because the big day is coming. Hallelujah. And right now in the body of Christ, there's a great need for the church of Jesus Christ to look up and to begin to expect the Messiah. Jesus is coming back soon. It's important for you and for me to prepare our hearts and to say, hey, Father, I hear the sound of the trumpet. Glory to God. And I'm going to prepare myself and be ready to meet the King. Hallelujah. That was the sound of the trumpet. But then the second thing, the trumpet, the Feast of Trumpets also coincided with the beginning of the new year. It was a new year blow as well, because Israel had the religious calendar and then they had the civil calendar, just like we have our normal January to December, and we have the financial calendar. We have June to June is another year, but we have January to December as 1 year. Now here's the thing, glory to God, the trumpets were blown to say it's time, a new year is beginning. A new season is at hand. Glory to God. A new season is here. And so it's a time of freshness. It's a time of new beginnings. It's a time to begin afresh on a clean slate. Now, let me just share with you something, brothers and sisters. Again, you follow that calendar of God. This coming year, now the year that we are beginning already, we have begun with this, the 14th of September, the Feast of Trumpets. This particular Feast of Trumpets ushered in a new year, yes. But it also, this new year that is being ushered in happens to be a Jubilee year on God's calendar. It's a year 5776. And in the Hebrew, they say it's called the year Ayin Vav. Ayin Vav is the letters of the Hebrew. No big deal about them. But one of the things that is very interesting about the Hebrew letter, Hebrew language, is their letters are symbols. They are small pictures. And the year Ayin Vav is symbolized by a hammer and a peg. Glory to God. It's like it's time to stretch your tent, secure your tent, and fasten your tent, because God is making room for you. So the new year that is coming is a year of great enlargement, great increase, hallelujah, that is coming to you and I in the body of Christ. This year that is coming is a jubilee year. Do you know what a wonderful blessing that is? You may have had the celebrations of the jubilee year of Kenya and all the things that happened at that time, and maybe you didn't really participate too much, or things happened and you are not really able to tap into that. But let me tell you, not to worry, glory to God, we have another opportunity now on God's calendar, not on Kenya's calendar now, but on God's calendar now. And God is saying it's a year of jubilee, it's a year of restoration. Jubilee was a season when there was restoration. There was a time of returning. Those who are captured and who were in slavery would return to their families. They would be released. They would go home rejoicing. There would be a restoration. All the re's you can think of. Restoration. Return. Release. Rejuvenation. Refreshing. Hallelujah. Those are all the characteristics of the time of Jubilee. And so God is saying, church, the year that is coming is a season of jubilee. You and I need to tap into that. We need to align ourselves with the timing of God and say, oh God, not according to Kenya's calendar, but according to your calendar, you're bringing us into a new season, a season to recover, a season to restore, a season to take back everything the enemy stole from us. I'm now taking back by faith in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me just tell you, my brother, my sister, this is the time to arise. Whatever you have lost, whatever was missing in your life, everything that the enemy has stolen from you, whether it was a relationship, and I want to be clear about that. There are certain relationships you can recover. There are certain relationships you need to let go. But if it's a relationship you're supposed to recover, you need to apply your faith now and say, God, I recover my relationship. The enemy will not separate me and my family. I recover the children that God gave me. They will not go to drugs and be alcoholics. No, God, I recover my family. I recover my children. I recover my business. I recover my ministry. I recover my faith. I recover my joy. I recover my passion. I recover my strength. In the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody shout. It's a season of jubilee. And when you apply your faith, you draw from God. You bring down what God has prepared. You don't, don't let the year pass when you have not partaken of the blessings of the year. Hallelujah. Don't let this year pass and you haven't received and claimed back your lost things. Kanisa. Undie. Undie. Don't let the year pass without you capturing your victories and your purpose and your commission. The glory of God is available this year. Let me just say this. One of the things that happened in the year of Jubilee, there would be no work done the whole year. The whole year there was no work done. Why? Because, hallelujah, it was a command of God and all these other things were to happen. Land was to return. Oh, land. Land was to return to its proper owners. I just feel to say right now that there's some land that needs to return to its rightful owners. Glory to God. You are here, you've lost land, there's court cases, there's issues in the family, there's all kinds of cases. Listen, don't fight at the flesh level. Rise up at the spiritual level and say, God, it's a year of jubilee. I come to the court of heaven and I claim back my land. I claim back my property. Hallelujah. Come on, church. I'm telling you the truth. Listen, you can claim what God has prepared for you. It's the season to do so. When the season passes, you may start struggling again in your own strength and energy. Because right now, there's a window that is open. The heavens are open to exactly cause exactly that to happen. Hallelujah. Church. Hallelujah. Kamata. Kamata kabisa, kamata. Oh, glory to God, I declare restoration over this congregation. Whatever you've lost, whatever the enemy has stolen from you, Masokayapo Takasha, I can declare a restoration and a return to you. What is rightfully yours, no enemy shall steal, no devil shall take, no power shall steal from you. You are the blessed of the Lord. You are the sons and the daughters of the Most High. You deserve the blessing of Jehovah God. Therefore, receive back what is yours. Receive back what belongs to you. Receive back what God has ordained for you. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Whew. We are entering into a portal of time when God has opened the heavens to cause these particular things to happen right now. It's their Kairos moment. It's their time to be birthed. The baby has been waiting for all these 9 months, so to speak. And now the year of birthing, the year of giving birth is now. God has said, now you need to deliver. You've been pregnant so long. You've been pregnant for 17 years. You've been pregnant for 15 years. You've been pregnant the last 7 years. It's time to deliver. God has appointed a time for you. It's time to deliver. What time is it? It's time to deliver. It's time to give birth. It's time to recover. It's time to take back with no apologies. Glory to God. I don't know. I'm Bishop. I'm machine kusoka kwa point. Nikola point is ingini lakini hii machine kutoka hapa. Glory to God. Listen, my brother, my sister. There's something about you activating your faith. It won't just happen because it is, it's, you know, even the mother, when the season comes, she doesn't just sit there and say, give me penicillin, nipe penikila. Penikila itaua mpaka mtoto. Sa, kuna peni ingine ambayo ni mzuri, ni peni ya kuzalisha mtoto. In other words, the mother, what does the doctor say? Push! And the lady is like, what are you talking about? Do you know what you are saying at the push? Ebu, come here and push yourself. You think it's a joke? But the doctor is saying, push. Why? Because you must get involved. Something about you must participate in the process of bringing forth this baby. It's your baby. When you push, after you push, you forget you ever pushed. After you push, and the baby comes forth, you say, oh, I have a sweet baby. You forget all the pain. I want to announce Deliverance Church. Hey, it's time to push. It's time to push. It's time to push. 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 Hey. It's time to push. Push your baby out. Look at your neighbor, tell them, push your baby out. Push your baby out. Push your money out. Push your family out. Push your finances out. Push your calling out. Push your purpose out. Come on, shout, push. Wow. And during this year of Jubilee, there was no work to be done the whole year. So what did the people do? Did they just sit around and drink tea from morning until evening? Well, here's what could be done. That whole year when there was no work done, people had time now to bond and to catch up one with another. Hey, ndugu yangu, habari ya masiku. Nimeshikwa na kazi ya miaka mingi. Sasa nimepata nafasi ya kukuja kukutembelea.
Na kupumzika.
Na kupumzika. Iko kachai tukunye bwana. People had time to develop their relationships because there's no work to be done. Shamba hailimwi, carpentry haifanyiki, soldiers wamepumzika, mfalme anajienjoy kwa palace. There's nobody doing anything by command of God. God has commanded you shall not work for the whole year. So what do we do? I'll tell you what. You focus on relationship. You focus on relationship. You focus on relationship with God. And you focus on relationship with others. For one full year. Before you go back to work again. Woo! Hallelujah! Listen. In this hour, God is speaking and saying to those of us who are in the body of Christ, sahi si wakati wa kukwazana vile Pastor Theory alikuwa anasema. This is not an hour to have grudges and issues with people. Learn to put off issues. Repent and forgive. This is a year and a season for forgiveness to flow from your heart to other people's hearts, from their hearts to your heart. Let me just encourage you, my brother, my sister. If you need to deal with something with somebody, now is the time. Why? The tekiah has blown. The blast, the trumpets have sounded. Anytime Jesus can come. It's a year of Jubilee. By the way, when Jesus began his ministry, he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach the gospel to the poor. Bam, 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 bam. And to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord's favor. That is the year of Jubilee. Hallelujah. You and I are standing at the precipice of an incredible season and time. And you and I need to understand the times we are living in so we can apply our faith and align with God's plan so we can get the most out of this season. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hey! Hey! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God. I want us to pray right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, today it's not going to be a complicated altar call. It's a simple altar call. What relationship do you need to get right? There may be pending issues at home. Maybe you and your husband are not seeing eye to eye. Maybe you and your wife are not seeing eye to eye. Maybe you and your father, your mother have issues. Relationship issues, relationship issues, relational issues. Kukwazana, kukudharauliana, kuhepana. Every manner of relational issue. God wants you and I today to put that at the foot of the cross. Because let me tell you something. That's the best way to usher yourself into the year of Jubilee. It's a time for you to recover. It's time for you to get back everything God has given and purpose for you. I can't overemphasize how wonderful all the days ahead look. Hallelujah. There's so much that is in store for you and for me. The days are bright in the future. The days are wonderful. God has wonderful things, but it begins with you and I getting relationships right. Your pastor amekukwaza. Hakukuja hospitali siku ile ulikuwa mgonjwa. Ama hakutembelea aunti yako sasa ile alikuja hapa Nairobi. Ukampigia simu, alikuwa mteja. Na alipopata missed call yako hakukurudishia. Sasa umekwazika. I want to encourage you. Release those issues. Release those things. Release them. I feel a release, just a spirit of release coming. And I want us to pray. That's the first thing we're going to do. I want us to pray that God will release us from every relational issue. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Glory to your name, Father. Ah, kosaka tamandashaya borehi seketala. Father, I pray that the grace, the window of grace that is open in this day of Jubilee, my Father, this season that we are entering into, of the year of God's favor, my Father, I pray that every relationship issue will be dealt with and released from our hearts, and we shall live, God, day by day with pure hearts, without hurt, without offense, without hindrance. Mosharia kasaka. While our heads are bowed and we are praying, you're here and you're saying, you know what? Brother John, I want you just to pray with me. There's an issue of offense somewhere in my life. I want to get rid of it. Just raise your hand to the Lord right now. Let God just see your hand. That's all right. Just let God just release you right now. The grace is available. Oh, I have good news for you. Let's just keep our heads bowed as we pray in the name of Jesus. This is very personal. This is very, very personal. And we reverence the working of God right now. Let me tell you, this is awesome that God can give us a chance to enjoy the fullness of what he has purposed for us. But here's the thing. I want to encourage you right now, as your hand is raised, I want you to say with me, say, Father, I thank you for the grace of release. I release every individual that has offended me. I forgive them. By my own choice, whether they deserve it or not, by my own choice, I forgive them and I release them. Now, Father, release unto me the grace to enjoy this year of favor. Thank you, Father, for hearing my prayer. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. 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 Glory to God. Let's give God a hand clap. Shatasakataya. Glory to God. We want to finish our service this morning by praying for a second category of people. You're here and you don't have a relationship with God. You've never entered into a relationship, a covenant relationship with this wonderful God. Hey, my brother, my sister, listen. Now is the acceptable year of the Lord's favor. Now is the time that God has ordained for you to enjoy and to receive the blessings of salvation, redemption, and every other blessing that God can have for his people. And so, if you're here this morning and you want to say, hey, I want to partake of what God has prepared for my life. I don't want to stay outside relationship with God. I don't want to come 15 minutes too late. I want to come right on time. I want us to just bow our heads and pray right now in Jesus' name. Come on, let's just bow our heads in prayer. Father, I thank you for every brother, every sister that needs to make their relationship right with you this morning. Maybe you're here and you backslid and you're not really walking with God. You have an offense against God. God disappointed you. God didn't do this. God didn't do the other. And you're offended at God. Or you've never really given your life to Christ. And you're saying, Lord, today I hear the season. I hear the time. I've heard the trumpet. It's time for me to get ready to repent and to come into right relationship with God. If you're here and that's your situation this morning, hey, I want to invite you right now. Just raise up your hand wherever you are. I want to pray for you right now. Quickly, just raise up your hand wherever you are in the service. Hallelujah. I want to pray for you. Lift your hand high so I can see it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I praise you and I give you glory. Wherever you are, if you're here, just raise your hand. Is there anybody in the house that wants to say, that's me. I want to connect with God. I want to relate with God. I want to enter into a relationship with the Most High God. Would you raise your hand and we pray for you? If I can't see, just wave. Yes, I see my brother back there. God bless you. Amen. Thank you over there, my brother. Yes, there's another hand over there. God bless you. Any other person, this is the season. Now is the time. You're saying, I don't want to miss the timing of God. I don't want to miss what God is doing. Stuck in your change. Nataka nikuwe ndani wakati Mungu anabariki watu wake. Mimi pia nataka kuwa ndani kabisa katika jina la Yesu. Hallelujah. Just raise your hand. Amen. God bless you, my sister. Thank you. Just keep raising your hand right now. We're going to pray for you. Yes, God bless you, my sister, in Jesus' name. Anybody else? Yes, over there, my brother. God bless you, in Jesus' name. Anybody else? Yes, my sister over here. God bless you. Glory to God. Anybody else? You're saying, this is the grace. Amen. Over there, back there. God bless you over there. God bless you. Hallelujah. Just anywhere you are, don't miss out. God's moving now. This is the hour of being right with God. God is moving in the power of the Spirit of God to make things right. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh, I feel so good. I feel the glory of God. I feel the grace of God. I feel the power of God. Hallelujah. Going, moving in this house right now, touching lives, changing destinies in the name of Yeshua. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, those of you who have your hands raised, come. Just come here at the front. I want to meet you right now and pray for you. Yes, just come. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Come. Thank you, my sister. Amen. Thank you, my sister. Come. Yes. God bless you. God bless you over there at the back. Yes, come. Come. Come, my sister over here. God bless you. Just come. Yes. Oh, glory to God. I love this guy. Come on. I appreciate him. God bless you, young man. God bless you, young man. Come on. Amen. Amen. Let's come on. God bless you, my sister. Amen and amen. God bless you. Wonderful. Yes, just come. Yes, over there. Come. God bless you. Come, my sister. God bless you. Wonderful. Yes, just come, my sister. Come. Let's appreciate them. Hoshaka talaba kotalaba. Rantolobo sika talabando. Jekatalabo palakasata. Roko satala kamande shekayaba. Oh, we break the power of deception. We break the power of fear. We break the power of religion. We break the power of the devil. Now, in the name of Jesus. In this house, we break the power of the enemy. Glory to God. Praise God. Hallelujah. I tell you, God is moving right now. God is moving right now. I feel there's three more guys that need to respond. Three more people. Where are you? Just come join them. We won't take too long. We're just going to finish right now. But we're going to open this window of time. Just come. Yes, God bless you, my sister. Come. There's two more people. Don't hesitate. Yes, come. come. God bless you, my sister. God bless you. Come. There's one more person. I think one or two more people. Yes. Come. Come over there. Come. Come. Yes. Yes. Come. 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 Yes. Come. 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 God bless you. God bless you. Reshayatu kamandasa. Rekotapala kamantosho. Ah, deception, I break your hold. You will not lie to any person under the sound of this service in the name of Yeshua. Rekasotalabaka. Satan, you're a liar. I bind you, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We lose the people of God. We lose the sons of God. We lose the daughters of God. We lose the people of God. We lose them to be saved. Yes. Glory to God. Glory to God. We want to pray for these individuals who are here. I tell you, the glory of God is in this place. God is good. Hallelujah. Those of you who are here in the front, congratulations. 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 Wow. Wow. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Wow, God bless you. I want to invite the ministry team this morning to just come and just lay hands on these and just pray for them. Just a short prayer. Let's pray. Let's lead them through the prayer of salvation. And then I want to request if the ministry team, please, if you can just lay your hand on them and just pray, speak something. Just decree prophetically into their life. Declare the will of God. I love these guys. Oh, let's move over to our left. Let's move to our left. Let's move to our left. Let's move to our left a little bit. All of us, tusonge kwa mkono wa kushoto kidogo. Hallelujah. Just come. Yes, 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 yes. God bless you. God bless you. Come, come, come. Yes, we pray. We pray. We pray. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now, God is good. Praise the Lord. Let's minister to him. Can we just pray the prayer of salvation first? Minister team, if you can pray, let's pray the prayer of salvation corporately, and then you'll speak over their life and proclaim the word of God. While ambao mmekuja hapa mbele, we want to help you to pray a simple prayer to invite Jesus into your life and to change, for God to change your status from somebody who is not born again to someone who is born again. And church, can we pray together with them? Can we just pray the salvation prayer together with them? Amen. Let's pray together. Say, Father. Let's pray together, all of us, especially those here in the front. Let's say with me, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you today. I know I am a sinner. But Father, I thank you for the Spirit of God who has touched my heart. I now open my heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God. Come into my life. Wash me with your precious blood. Cleanse me from all my sin. Make me a child of God. Write my name in your book of life. Thank you. I believe with my heart that I am saved, that I've received eternal life. And I will live forever with you. In Jesus' name I pray. Everybody say it, amen. Woo! Hallelujah! Now, church, we're going to just praise the Lord while the ministry team just takes 1 minute to pray over them. Maybe if you've already prayed over them, that's okay. But if you need to pray over them, ministry team, please just pray for them and just speak something over their life. Father, even you, church, let's just pray. Father, we bless them. We pray they have got these who have gotten born again in the season of Jubilee. We pray that they will live under the grace of Jubilee. Ho, 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 ho. My God, my God, my God, my God. They'll live under the grace of Jubilee. They'll live under the grace of Jubilee. All the days of their salvation life, they will live under the grace of Jubilee, my Father. Your presence will come upon them. Your peace. Ah! Oh! Shalabo kereba talama kokaya. Yemando sakapaliato. Lika sanda labahe. Roko salabaya. Lemonga labasikayako talaba. Ha ha. Oh, we break the powers of hell from their life. We release them to believe. We release them to walk with God. They will not backslide. They will not backslide. We speak deliverance over their lives. Oh, Father. My God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And everybody said, Amen.
I want them to just be taken, the little bit of a Christ away. So if they're picking it in the bag, pick your bag. The teachers who are here, let's help them so that they don't go back to their seats, but they go to class straight away.
Let's make a joyful noise in the house, shall we? Let's appreciate the Lord. Yeah!